وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, I want to speak about some of the virtues of fasting. The virtues of fasting, my beloved brothers and sisters, is large in number. The virtues that have come are great. Some virtues are restricted to Ramadan, and some virtues is for every form of fasting. So I won't be going through that here, inshallah ta'ala. What I'll be speaking about is some of its virtues. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us that Allah azza wa jalla said, and this is hadith Qudsi, كُلُّ عَمَلِ ابْنِ آدَمَ لَهُ. Every action that the slave does is for him. إِلَّا الصَّوْمَ فَإِنَّهُ لِي. As for fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, it is for me. وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. I am the one that's going to reward it. لَخُلُوفُ فَمِ الصَّائِمِ أَطْيَبُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ رِيحِ الْمِسْكِ. The odor and the smell that comes from the mouth of the person who is fasting is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the fragrance of misk. The misk and the smell that comes from the person who is fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the fasting person's smell. It's powerful. ولذلك, some of the scholars, what they took from this hadith is that the fasting is more virtuous and greater than martyrdom, shahada. Naam. Fasting is better than martyrdom, shahada, according to some of the scholars. And where they got this from is the hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke about the martyr, the day of judgment. And the Prophet said, the blood gushing from him, the Prophet said, "Al-lawnu lawnu dami." The blood, the color of it, is the color of the blood. وَالْرِيحُ رِيحُ الْمِسْكِ. But the smell of the martyr's blood is like the smell of the misk. Whereas the one who is fasting, the smell that comes from his mouth is better than the misk. So from here they took, Allah Azza wa Jalla in the Hadith al-Qudsi gave more virtue to the one who is fasting than the martyr. The virtues that are in fasting is also another virtue that the Prophet mentioned, which is أَصَّوْمُ جُنَّةٌ يَسْتَجِنُّ بِهَا الْعَبْدُ مِنَ النَّارِ. Fasting is a shield that a person shields himself from the hellfire. If you want to protect yourself from the hellfire, fasting is a means to protect yourself from it. الإمام المناوي in his kitab فيد القدير, عبد الرؤوف المناوي, he said, شبه الصوم به لأنه يحمي الصائم عن الآفات النفسية في الدنيا وعن العقاب في الأخرى. The way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made the fasting similar to a shield is because the fasting protects the person from committing the internal sins, the sins that come from the soul and the nafs. The nafs pushes you to evil. It protects you from that in this world, and it protects you from the punishment of Allah yawm al-qiyamah. So in this dunya, you're not going to come up with wanting to do evil if you're fasting, because what fasting does is it castrates your desires. And the day of judgment, it protects you from the hellfire. This is a great virtue for fasting. Also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, من صام يوما في سبيل الله بعد الله وجهه عن النار 70 خريفا. Anyone who fasts a day for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will distance his face from the hellfire 70 خريفا. 70 years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect your face from the hellfire. This is a high station, a great station. Anyone who fasts a day, and you only fast for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're only doing this for whose sake? Allah azza wa jalla. Allah will distance your face from the hellfire 70 years. The days of fasting, in it are days where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is freeing a group of people's necks from the hellfire. Every single day that goes by in Ramadan, there are a group of people Allah is freeing them from the hellfire. And that's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَلِلَّهِ عُتَقَاءُ مِنَ النَّارِ وَذَلِكَ كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ. Every single night in Ramadan, there are people who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is freeing their necks from the hellfire. They have been taken away from being from the dwellers of the hellfire, and they have been put on the list of the people who are going to go to paradise. May Allah make us from them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, مَنْ خُتِمَ بِصِيَامِ يَوْمٍ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. Anyone who for them, their final act which they do is to fast, then they're going to enter Jannah. If what you die upon is fasting, that is the last thing you did, you will enter Jannah. Al-Imam al-Manawi rahimahullah, he said, أي من ختم عمره بصيام يوم بأن مات وهو صائم أو عقب صومه دخل الجنة أي بغير عذاب. Al-Imam al-Manawi rahimahullah, he said, anyone, he's explaining the hadith that we just mentioned, any individual whose final act and his life comes to an end, him fasting or her fasting, they died whilst fasting, that person will enter Jannah. He said it means بغير عذاب, without any punishment. And they will enter Jannah straight away. Allahu Akbar. That's a great virtue. You'll be protected from the hellfire. You will go to Jannah straight away. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us, he said, من صام من أهل الصيام دعي من باب الريان. Anyone who fasts from those who are the people of fasting, they will be called from the door of الريان. There's a door specific for the people who fasted. This door is called Bab al-Rayyan. No one else enters it except the people who fasted. Why was this door called al-Rayyan? What was the reason why it was given this name? Al-Qadhi Riyad rahimahullah al-Yahsubi, he explains the reason for this. He said, قِيلَ لَمَّا كَانَ فِي الصَّوْمِ الصَّبْرِ. When there was inside the fasting, patience was required. The person has to be very patient. And the patience that is required from the person is three types. Fasting from sins. So that's a form of patience. There's three types of patience that's in fasting. The first one is from sins. The second one is obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third one is calamities and hardships that you go through. These three are present in fasting. The highest one that you see is to stay away from sins and also to do the staying away from sins and also doing what you are told to do. The biggest thing that you have to do is you have to stay away from thirst, drinking. Your nafs wants it. It's calling you to it. So Qadhi Iyad says, لَمَّا كَانَ فِي الصَّوْمِ الصَّبْرُ عَلَى الْعَطَشِ فِي الْهَوَاجِرِ سُمِّيَ الْبَابُ الَّذِي يُدْعَى مِنْهُ بِثَوَابِهِ عَلَى ذَلِكَ وَهُوَ مَشْتَقٌ مِّنَ الرَّيْءِ. He said, since fasting, it requires patience. Patience from thirst. At the hot days when the sun is burning, the door in which that person will be called from the Day of Judgment is called Bab al-Rayyan. And the word al-Rayyan is mushtaqqun min al-ri, sorry. Mushtaqqun min al-ri. And the word al-Rayyan is rooted from the word Arri. Arri means what? Thirst. And that is why the door of the people who are fasting is called Babur Rayyan. Because they went through thirst for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-jaza'u min jinsil amal. That the reward is in accordance to the action of the person. Inshallah ta'ala, today's episode, that was what I intended to cover. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan. And Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.